What's up, guys? Welcome back to 31 Days of Halloween, and we have quite the doozy today because who doesn't like a good revenge tale? And really, if you're gonna make a revenge tale, what better name than revenge? A little on the nose, but I mean, I feel like it really fits. This is a I Spit on Your Grave style movie where a girl, spoiler alert. So this girl, she's out in the middle of nowhere with a bunch of couple guys, and things take a bad turn. She gets raped by, I don't know what this guy's name is, I just called him Beardy McGee throughout, and he is the creepiest motherfucker that you could possibly imagine. Not only that, but he is the most inconsistent coward I have ever seen in one of these types of movies. Not inconsistent in terms of, like, bad character. It's still very well written. It's just, this guy is a fucking asshole. And I think it pretty much represents sexual predators in general. So when he finally gets his comeuppance, it's really fucking nice. Really nice. Because he's just a dick. A dick in every way. You get it's a basic revenge I Spit on Your Grave story, but it just ramps up to 11. And even there's a drug that even like helps her. It just explains how the fuck she can take this big of a beating. Because sometimes in movies like this, you're like, how are they still alive? How? So I like that. And once the deaths actually start happening, oh, they are very satisfying. The film just, it's so tense throughout. Every shot will linger, everything. It's all about building that tension. And holy fuck. The cinematography on this film, it might end up being some of the best cinematography for the entire month because I was blown away. There's just these lush desert landscapes, and the DP on this knew what they were doing. Really knew what they were doing. Though, I don't understand. Does anyone know why half of this movie is in, I believe, French, and then the other half is English? Like, it didn't make much sense to me at all. I didn't understand, like, was that, like, a financial decision based on, like, backers? Or why? It didn't make a whole lot of sense. Maybe it was creative, and it was just to further separate the girl from these guys. But I didn't understand why. I didn't mind it because I don't mind subtitles, but once they started speaking English, I was like, wait a minute, this is an English-speaking film? And it just kind of goes back and forth throughout, and it's just kind of odd. But yeah, I just loved how everything unfolded in this. It was well shot, well acted, and I fucking hated every one of those guys. Every one of them. Which, in a movie like this, that's what you want. You want to be rooting against these assholes, so bravo, bravo. There was one little thing that kind of annoyed me a tad, and this is, I feel like, I doubt I'm in the minority. There is one scene, it's right at the end, where they are literally in cat and mouse, they're chasing each other around in a circle. It's in a house, so they're like going through hallways and stuff, but it's a circle, and they're following each other trying to catch up, and I just wanted to be like, fucking stop! All you gotta do is one of you stop, and then you'll catch up. It's real fucking simple. So that was enough to almost make me drop my rating of it. But honestly, it was the preceding scene still hit hard, still was good. I can't go against the movie for that. So what can you do? But that's all for day 12. Tomorrow we have a doozy. This is a brand new film from the director of The Raid 1 and 2, Gareth Evans. And that's right, we're doing Apostle. Oh, I cannot wait for this one. I hope you guys are pumped too. I'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, you can feel free to hit that subscribe button below and follow me on Twitter, Instagram, or Letterboxd. I am at Zombie Victim on all of them. Thanks.